Hello and welcome to NewsClick. State elections are around the corner in Haryana neighboring Delhi, in the western Indian state of Maharashtra, and the far northeastern state of Arunachal Pradesh. While this may not have very great consequences or ramifications for the Indian polity as a whole, some of these state elections are certainly going to have significance in the short to medium term. To discuss these elections, we have with us today Shankar Raghuraman of the Times of India.
Hello.
Shankar, these elections, there's only three of them, but some of them are in fairly major states, and certainly the elections in Maharashtra will have some bearing on national
Absolutely.
Politics. How do you see this turning out?
The elections in Maharashtra, as far as they have a bearing on national politics, I would say there are two areas in which they could have an impact. One, of course, is that the Congress and the Nationalist Congress Party, the NCP, led by Mr. Pawar, since they are in an alliance, and it's not a very comfortable alliance, it's always been an uneasy alliance, how well, in relative terms, the two partners do will have a bearing on whether Mr. Pawar gets cut to size in New Delhi or gains some clout. Similarly, within the BJP Shiv Sena alliance, the Shiv Sena is in the state clearly the major partner. The BJP is the junior partner. But the BJP also has been chaffing for quite some time and has for long believed that it should soon take over the mantle of the senior partner in that alliance. So there again, the relative performance of the two partners will have an impact on which way the things progress in future.
The waters in the Maharashtra political scene seem to have got extremely muddied, particularly with the emergence of the MNS of Raj Thackeray, the expectation that he has substantially eaten into the vote bank of the Sena. How do you see the MNS impact this time, especially compared to the Lok Sabha election?
Well, in the Lok Sabha elections, the MNS, the Maharashtra Navnirman Samiti, they polled about 4% of the vote statewide, which seems like very little if you look at it in those terms. But the fact that this vote was largely concentrated in the Mumbai Thane region, where they got over 20% of the vote, made a crucial difference to the outcome of the elections.
In several constituencies.
Oh yes, I think the Congress won a lot of the seats in the Mumbai Thane region, precisely because the MNS ate into the BJP Shiv Sena votes in such a large measure. If it hadn't, I mean, as a result of this, what happened was that the Congress NCP alliance won 25 of the 48 Lok Sabha seats,
right,
whereas the BJP Shiv Sena finished with 20. If the MNS had not been such a factor, you could well have had a reversal of that.
And this time we are likely to see more of the same?
Well, typically, localized parties tend to do much better in state assembly elections than they do in a national election. So if that logic holds, then you would expect, yes, you would expect the MNS to perform even better in the state assembly election. And if that happens, presumably, it will impact the BJP Shiv Sena even more this time.
Although we are saying that these elections are going to have an impact on the national scene because of the way these parties may perform and then therefore determine their relative weights, my own assessment seems to be that the elections in Maharashtra this time are quite uniquely issueless elections. They seem to be being played out just in numbers. And ultimately, it's just the numbers game which is going to determine what's going to happen. Am I right?
Well, I wouldn't say it's an issueless election, but I would agree with you that there is no party, none of the four major parties in the state seems to be able to appeal to the electorate on a positive agenda.
Right.
I mean, to that extent, it is issueless in the sense that there is no real appeal that is discernible for either of the fronts. They both seem to be depending on winning by default, as it were.
Quite.
The Shiv Sena BJP is hoping that the third front, as it's called, the RSLDF, which is a coming together of various small parties with the left party, that will eat into the Congress NCP vote bank, and therefore that they will win by default. The Congress, on the other hand, is expecting the MNS to do similar damage to the rival front.
So, how do you see the third front performing and the RPI, the Republican Party factions?
Well, the fact of the matter is that the Republican Party factions, though they have an illustrious history, going back to Dr. Ambedkar himself, they have not, in the recent past, made too much of an impact. They have held on to pockets of influence. And partly the reason has been that they have fragmented. There's something like 15 factions of the RPI, though some are clearly more meaningful than others. I mean, the group led by Ramdas Athawale, the former MP, is obviously the most powerful of the RPI factions. Now, whether they're coming together makes a difference. It's also true that when a party breaks up into various fragments, the sum total of those small fragments doesn't add up to what it would have been as a single entity. Now, whether this coming together helps them to increase their votes remains to be seen. They also, unfortunately for them, they're coming together at a point when the BSP is also presenting itself as a rival for more or less the same vote bank. But if you take the RPI factions, then you take the Peasants and Workers Party, which has an area of influence quite distinct from the RPI. You have the left, you have the Samajwadi Party. All of this put together, I don't think will make a meaningful front in terms of winning seats, but it could make a significant difference.
In particularly,
I think in the Vidarbha region, it will have an impact on the Congress NCP votes.
Right. I think particularly because each of them has quite distinct pockets of influence.
Quite right.
Which don't come together to make sufficient difference in a first
Yes, so they probably can't get beyond the threshold value to actually win seats.
Yeah. Last question on Maharashtra before we move on. Is the Sena tiger going to continue to roar, or is the mantle going to be passed to the MNS?
All indications are that the chauvinist core of the Sena, clearly that agenda has been taken over by Raj Thackeray. There is no, I don't think there is any gain saying that. Whether that also translates into a shift in votes, it remains to be seen. But I think clearly he is setting the agenda, and the Sena has become the reactant. I mean, it's reacting to what Raj Thackeray is doing.
Haryana, the elections seem to be heading for a foregone conclusion, with the incumbent likely to continue his dominance in the state. Do you see this that way?
Yes, very much. I mean, one clear reason for that is that the opposition is split four ways. I mean, the BJP is contesting without an alliance this time. Mr. Chautala's INLD is on its own. Mr. Bhajanlal's Haryana Janhit Congress is on its own. And the BSP is a very credible fourth option. So, I mean, if you look at what happened in the Lok Sabha elections, the Congress got about 42% of the vote. Each of these four parties was between 10 and 15% of the vote. So, that, I mean, if you get a repeat of that situation, it's pretty much a sweep for the Congress. The other indication that this is likely to happen is the nature of the campaign that the Congress has been running. If you've noticed, it's been very Huda-centric. I mean, the ads have all been centered on the chief minister, which is very unusual for a Congress campaign.
Yeah.
Congress campaigns typically tend to play up the high command, Sonia ji and so on. That's not been happening in this election. So clearly the Congress perceives itself on a very strong wicket there.
Do you think the BSP, given the social composition in the state, is likely to be able to replicate the kind of social engineering did in UP, where it was able to attract other caste groups and social groups into a broader coalition? Because one of the factors that may restrict it in Haryana to this 15% is that it may keep getting the same 15% in different constituencies, but it will not be able to cross the threshold required to be able to win seats in the assembly.
Well, my answer to that would be, if it believes that it can do it through social engineering, it will not succeed. I mean, if the BSP tries to basically put together a sort of caste coalition, I don't think that is a workable proposition, not in Haryana.
Not in Haryana.
It could theoretically be possible in Punjab, where there's a very large right. proportion of Dalits. I don't think it'll work in Haryana. But on the other hand, you must remember that in the last assembly elections in UP, while a lot was said and written about social engineering and how the Brahmins voted for the BSP and so on, I think a much more correct understanding, a more correct reading of that result was that a lot of the vote which was disillusioned with the Samajwadi Party actually gravitated towards the BSP irrespective of caste.
Right.
So I think there is a lesson in that for the BSP. If it can emerge as a credible alternative to the incumbent in Haryana without positing itself as a caste-based party,
right.
I think that is the way forward for the BSP, not just in Haryana, but in the rest of the country as well. It cannot depend purely on a caste-based arithmetic.
Right. Thank you, Shankar.